in physical capital explain. Dear students, if such type of question is asked to you, then you can answer that suppose, why do your parents spend money on your education, health and other professional education? Like your parents send you Rajasthan, Delhi, Haryana, Punjab for preparation of for professional education like in engineering and medical. You expect to your parents that your parents send you to Kota for better coaching, for admission in engineering and medicals. Why do you expect so to your parents? Why do your parents spend so huge money on your education? Why do your parents spend money when you fall ill on your treatment? Do they spend money on these things hoping more income earned by you in future? Because you are the future generation. They will depend upon you, on your future, on you in future, when their physical ability will be lost. As I also hope to you that you will be better, and whenever you will meet me, then I shall hope some better to you, your better treatment to you. Spending money on these things makes you more educated or the better trained. And more education and better training increase your productivity like investment on other physical resources. Thus, investment in human capital yields a return in just like investment in physical capital in future. Dear students, sometimes a question is asked that how is society also gains in indirect ways through more educated and healthier group of people. Dear students, more educated and healthier people spread consciousness about education and health among uneducated and unhealthier group of people. It means educated and healthier people share their thinkings to their neighbors about the benefits and advantages of health and education, and they are inspired by you, and they also think to educate and to make healthier to their children. Thus we see that educated and healthier people spread consciousness among the uneducated and unhealthier group of people in a society. Next, in fact, human capital is superior than other resources like land and capital. dear students, whenever people would have not the skill and knowledge for using land and capital, then the land and physical capital like land and capital would be useless. By their knowledge and their technology, human capital or human resource make the physical capital like land and capital productive. That's why human capital is superior than the other resources. Next, earning of educated and healthier people is shared by unhealthy and uneducated group also. Suppose when you were uneducated, your earning was very low and you bought only a half liter of milk per day. Now you become educated, healthier, and your productivity is more. You earn more than before. Now you buy 2 liters of milk per day. It means your earning is shared by those people who are uneducated and unhealthy. Thus we see that society also gains from the educated, from the earning by educated and healthier people. Next, land and capital cannot become useful on its about which I have discussed before. Dear students, all these things we will discuss in details in future through the 2 cases illustrated in the text, like the story of Sakal and a story of Vilas. That how is education, training and health important to make human as a capital, human as a resource, and for human capital formation. These 2 cases will tell in details about the importance of education, healthcare, and training to make the population as a resource. Thank you. Okay.